old weather proverbs such as ring around the moon, rain real soon, or red sky at night, sailors delight. Red sky in the morning, sailors take warning. Were all used to describe the short-term forecast. These sayings were based on the appearance of clouds or the condition of the sky. Many of these proverbs used by farmers in the very old days were excellent forecasts and are still used today. In 1804, Luke Howard, an amateur meteorologist from England, developed a classification scheme based on the appearance of the cloud formation. There are essentially three basic cloud forms: stratiform, cumuliform, and cirrus. These forms are defined from the Latin terms that describes their appearance in the sky. For example, stratus in Latin is translated as layered. Clouds that exhibit a layering effect will contain the root stratus. Cumuliform describes the cloud's appearance as being stacked. Finally, cirrus clouds are defined as hair-like. Each cloud type is categorized according to the basic form, very low to high altitude. Learning the different cloud types is relatively easy if you notice the patterns, size, and height. It is important to remember that these are basic cloud types, and it is possible that nature can provide several different cloud combinations within a single day or even hour. Stratus clouds exhibit a layered appearance due to the gradual incline of relatively weak winds associated with an oncoming warm front. As the wind blows, cloud droplets are spread across the sky, giving a layered appearance. Stratus clouds are typical of the stratiform definition, layered at the low altitude. It is the cloud that provides for a gloomy day. Altostratus clouds are found within the middle altitude. When the sun shines behind this cloud, the cloud appears milky and fibrous. Cirrostratus clouds are found in the higher altitudes. A halo around the sun or moon can be used to identify this cloud. This cloud is mostly made of ice crystals and gives the appearance of a very thin film with the disk of the sun or moon extremely distinct. Cumulus clouds are just as they are defined, large, white, puffy clouds. These clouds are typical of a fair weather day. Altocumulus clouds are smaller than cumulus and often positioned in rows. These clouds can often display a mackerel sky. Cirrocumulus clouds are the smallest of this class of cloud and arrange themselves in rows in higher altitudes. Cirrus clouds, defined as hair-like, are clouds that exhibit a streakiness, as if they were pulled apart like cotton candy. There is only one cloud associated with this form, which is only found in the higher altitudes. Nimbostratus clouds are clouds that look like the stratus cloud, but produce precipitation. This cloud is found in the very low altitudes. The only cloud that extends from the low altitude to the high altitude is considered the king of all clouds, the cumulonimbus. This cloud often exhibits an anvil top and produces thunderstorms. Meteorologists and weather enthusiasts use cloud classification to understand how the immediate atmospheric environment is evolving and can determine a general forecast. For example, stratiform clouds are commonly associated with an oncoming warm front. If you see cirrostratus clouds and then altostratus and stratus move in, you can generally expect warmer temperatures and a chance of rain showers in the next few hours. When the region experiences thunderstorms ahead of a cold front, you can generally expect cooler temperatures and clear skies with a few cirrus clouds the next day.